love bugs, it's Roslynn back at you one more again. I hope everybody is doing blessed. I'm doing blessed and highly favored, and definitely hope the same for you. So if this is your first time stopping by my channel, much love to you and welcome into my returning subs, my growing extended beautiful family. Just thank you so much for the love and support, being able to take time out for yourself, see where you need to heal at, let go of what you need to let go of, and keep on moving. So with that being said, much love to all. Namaste, love and blessings, love and light. And many blessings are definitely coming your way. And if you have been watching my videos for a while and have not already, please like and subscribe. Even hit that notification bell at the bottom so you know when your girl's about to upload her next video. Also, if you are comfortable enough, please drop me a line. I would love the chance to get to know you as much as you're getting to know me. Even if it's about the positive feedback or the content of my video, or you're just up telling me about your impact, the gift, and how it impacts your life and heading you towards a positive direction. Also, if you feel like the video is gave you good vibes or good information you would love to share with a loved one, family, or friend, please go ahead and do so. And while you're at it, give me a thumbs up, like, and also share on your social media favorites wherever you see fit. And once again, thank you so much for the love and support. It's so greatly appreciated. And I hope you're able to, resonate. I don't know why I say recognize. Resonate with the content of my video. And today, meditation music I'm listening to is called Buddhist Meditation Music for Positive Energy, Buddha Seed, Buddha Music, Calming Music, and I will post that link in the description box below. And today my video is about Twin Flame 101, Heyokas. Keep telling yourself there's always a divine purpose for all these experiences you go through. And it truly is. I mean, sometimes at that point in time when we're going through things, it's hard to actually see why we had to go through those things. No matter if it's a good situation or a bad situation, we always learn from certain things, and we have to know it's deeper than, you know, we actually realize. It could be something very little, or it can be very very big, whatever occurs in your life. And, you know, and it teach you one way or another that, hey, you know, yeah, this might have sucked about this and this and this, that situation, but look at what it brought you. You know, just like there's times, you know, when you probably in toxic situations, like with relationships, it doesn't have to mean just with a significant other. It can be with your parents, co-workers, or just, you know, and significant others. That is like all those situations has taught you something, like with mine, you know, doing my videos. It's just like going through all the different things, whether it's good situation or a bad situation, I'm able to put those into words, being able to, you know, help people along the way to let you know you're not alone, you're not going crazy. Even when you feel like you're alone, you always have support from places you don't even know. And when you're going through very hard situations that happens in your life, and you're so ready to get out of it, trust me, I know, but there's always something that you needed to learn in that situation. And it's just like, if you're still in a situation, and you're working hard just to be able to get though, you know, get onto your next level. You keep seeing signs that everything is there. You know, you probably read numbers. I know I read numbers a lot, you know, especially if they mirror each other. You know, they got the same number ending with the same number and just one in between, or even all three. It's like right before I did my video, I seen 8888, you know, my videos, and I was just like, ooh, that's a blessing. So it's just like, even with my, during my hardship, I know my experience has been very painful, but it allowed me to love myself in ways I wasn't able to love myself. Being able to walk away from people that did no longer serve me. I always had to constantly have somebody around me, because it was just like before my spiritual awakening, before actually I was going through one and didn't realize what I was going through. I had lost my job, and, you know, it was supposed to be with, I thought was a good friend of mine, and, you know, she turned her back on me, and it was just a blessing, because it was just like, you weren't meant to be there anyway. You know, this job was only supposed to serve its purpose, and then you post part ways, you know. And even when I seen the girl, well, the lady, probably, what is it, about 4 or 5 months later, you know, and I even told myself, if I see her, I'm gonna just give her a hug and, you know, go on about my business. And, you know, she found out situations about me. I don't know how she found out, but it's neither here nor there. But, you know, she was like, oh, I heard about such and such supposed to be your family member and stuff like that, and I really miss you. And I'm just like, yeah, right. You know, you're trying to get some out of that situation. But it was just like, everything happens for a reason. And, you know, going through my situation has helped me being able to let go and see the positive that I need to go through. You know, there are certain things I'm still holding on that I'm getting past. You know, it's just regardless of what all we, you know, we're going through, and it can be very stressful. Spirit guides always sends us that message. It's like, yes, we know the situation sucks for you, but always look at the positive outlook, that you're the goals you're trying to reach out in your life, the things that you're wanting desperately in your life to change. We're sending you messages to let you know that this holds a divine purpose in your life. It was like, for me, my situation allowed me to not judge people, you know, try to see things towards the bigger picture, having faith when you felt like faith wasn't there anymore, you know, practicing patience, because it's just like, you know, you can ask for patience in your life. And it's like, when you ask for patience in life, God will put things in your life that you have no choice but to be patient for. You know, when you want faith, you really truly want to believe in something, you know, even though there's been so many hardships in your life, those hardships represent strength. That hardship represents you having love for yourself, not allowing anybody else to do that kind of damage to you. Whatever you went through, it helped you learn, like, what to look for, what certain people's to avoid. You know, us as empaths, we get that spider sense that, you know, there could be something that's going on with somebody, you just can't put your finger on it. It's just everything that you learn is very therapeutic for you, only if you can be able to step out the box and see the bigger picture, you know. And it's just like, before, like I told you, I didn't know if I was going to be able to do videos to help other people during their times of need, but didn't realize how my videos were placing that effect on people, allowing them to see things in a different way, doing things in a different perspective. You know, that's what Heyokas do. We have a weird way of showing you the things that you need to pay attention to, that you're doing, or, you know, that you need to work on in your life, or even just give yourself congratulations for it. You know, because a lot of times we'll feel like, oh, you know, things haven't really changed, but it's just like certain things that you have done in your life, you're starting to do them differently. And you have to be able to give yourself credit for those situations. And it's just like with me, I feel it and feel everything and everyone, you know, at times. Sometimes I got to step back and be able to take that break for myself to know that, you know, hey, you need to go ahead and recharge, cleanse yourself, because, you know, you're taking on a lot. You know, being able to have visions about certain things, you know, like I tell y'all, I can see empaths just in that fetal position. You know how when you were little, you sit up with your knees towards your chest and just cry, because there's so many empaths who are going through traumatic situations and you're trying to find the best way how to heal from it, how to walk away from it. You know, you're going through all these different things, and it's just like, if you don't know what a spiritual awakening is and you see your life just falling apart left and right, that could be a very scary situation. You know, that's the reason why we have to go through those spiritual awakenings, because as empaths, we might not have known we were empaths at that time. You know, our higher selves, it's just, there's times I've seen myself being around a whole bunch of people on my higher self, and we're picking and choosing what life we want to lead before, you know, this time. So it's just really crazy, because at that time you were like that super soldier, you know, something I can't remember what movie I saw this in to basically compare it to, but it's just like, you know, you're under a lobotomy or whatever, you know, they allowed you to forget certain things in your life because you, as that super soldier, knew how to react to it, knew how to go about it, all this and that. But they had to place you in a different, you know, in that life that you picked out before you got here, and they wiped your memory. So you can be, you know, that empath situation, that switch hasn't been switched off yet. So you've been having those situations dormant in you, to where, you know, growing up, there was something about you that you couldn't put your finger on, or even come up the words. You know, it's off the tip of your tongue, but you just didn't know how to vocalize it. You know, going through all these different things because, you know, you felt different. You know, you felt certain things when it comes to certain people. There are certain people that you drew yourself from. And it's just like, when I see my granddaughter, she is very intuitive, you know, very gifted, you know, because there are certain people, you know, like even sometimes when it comes to my ex, and she, you know, she's around when he's there, you know, she'll wave from a distance, but she'll back up, and I pay attention to that. I was like, okay. You know, and I think it's funny because she recognizes that she knows something that isn't right with that person. And it's just like, as children, we have to go back into that mindset because they're very intuitive when it comes to the spiritual realm. You know, they see things that, you know, us as an adults don't really see. When I pay attention to the things that I used to do as a child, I knew more about my past life, and it used to creep my adopted father out. Like, don't talk about stuff like that. That's weird. You know, my mom was like, you know, she's very special. You know, you shouldn't knock her down for that. And, you know, it just used to freak her out because I can tell her, oh, I died this time, mommy. You know, and this such and such was my brother at the time. I was a twin, but I died. And all those things. And it used to really trip her out. But she was very amused by it, too. You know, because she'll wait until her husband. I don't know why I call him my dad because I stripped him of that. But my mom's ex-husband would go away and then we'll start talking about certain things that she knew. You know, so when my real dad, when he would call, she would tell him, you know, she is so special. You know, I don't know if she told him about when I used to see him as a little child. You know, I told her, you know, my dad, Skipper, you know, it's just like when we used to play all the time, he'll be sitting up there and his astro, like he'll be astroplaning towards me. And we would always play Barbie dolls. He would always sit there in Indian style. And it would be funny because he would play with my Barbie dolls with me. And then when my mom comes in the room, he's like, shh. You know, and she's like, who are you in there talking to? She's like, tell him the skipper. Don't tell him my real name. Don't tell him my real name, you know. And didn't understand why he kept telling me that. But, you know, even before I started talking to my dad, I used to tell my mom, you know, is Prince my real dad? Or, you know, is he, you know, my twin brother? Because there's times I see him, he's my twin brother. And there's times I see him, he's my dad. This is before I even can get the concept of me being adopted. But that usually just freaked my mom out. And she's like, whoa. You know, so this situation has really been therapeutic for me. Even though, you know, I've lost so many people along the way. But I also know, you know, with the gifts that I have, I'm still able to talk to them. In the spirit realm, you know, I talk to my grams all the time. I talk to my grandfather a lot. You know, I talk to my mom and my two best friends that passed away as well. And that's a true gift for me, you know. And there's a lot of people that come back and say, you know, Roslynn, your videos are really helping me. And then it allows me to see I had to go through this tragedy. You know, there's a lot of people that gravitate towards me and they're like, I need help. I don't know, you know, this might sound crazy. I don't mean to unload everything on you. I said, this is what I do this for. I love to be able to help people because I know when I was going through my situation, I didn't have anybody I could reach out and talk to like that because there was a lot of things I didn't understand. I thought people might think I was crazy. You know, the last time I opened myself up, you know, people used that and ran with it and told people I was crazy because I was able to see, you know, people that has passed, or I can be able to see certain spirits that other people didn't. So they thought that was crazy. So it's just like, you know, if you're not fully awoke, you're not going to be able to know what I'm talking about. And yes, you will think I'm crazy. But it's just like now when I look at the situation, I feel like it's a blessing in disguise. Yeah, it sucks that I never was able to reconnect with my father, but I know there's a bigger picture behind that and all this stuff. But, you know, being able to deal with that, knowing I can talk to my loved ones that have passed away, you know, and they're rooting on for me and stuff like that. And being able to know when you have undergone something so strange and so heartbreaking, there's always a bigger picture that you have to be able to see. Because when everything's all said and done and you finally heal from all the things that was very traumatic in your life, that has really put you in a dark place, when you finally heal from that, that's the most beautiful situation. You know, just like I made the video about you coming out of the rabbit hole. You know, basically that's how our life is. You know, Alice, she had to clunk her head, you know, for all these things to happen for her to see how magical and beautiful things were. That's just like us. We had to have that bump on the head, that smack of reality of the spiritual awakening, to be able to endure and knowing there was something in us that lies dormant for so long. And it's like, okay, they done went through hell and high water back 4 or 5 times. Oh, okay, let's go ahead and flip this switch real quick. It really just throw you off balance. And then you're trying to understand, what the hell did I have to go through all this for? And then when everything's said and done, like with my situation, you know, I lost my grandparents. I lost my mother. I lost my dad. You know, all these different things. But look at all the people that I'm helping. You know, there, you know, I still have a blessing where I can talk to my dad every day. You know, there's times, you know, when he sees I'm sad or whatever, you know, he always tells me, go back to the times where we connected, go back to the times of our dreams, you know, and knowing that you can always talk to me all the time, I'm always right here to talk to me. So we have that telepathy that where we can still discuss. And as soon as I said that, my phone hit back up, my phone notification came up. So, you know, that's on point. So realize that, you know, that anything that you're going through, it has a deep divine purpose for you going through it. Don't be hard on yourself. Be gentle. Forgive yourself for allowing things to place that effect on you for so long. And, you know, you'll finally get the gist of the things that really happened for you. So I would love to tell Marisol Coleman, I hope that's your last name because I'm not looking at the paper, as well as Ray Fisher. Yeah, what is it? Yeah. I'm sorry, Marisol Coleman. Yeah, I got that right. Send out love and blessings. Give me a thumbs up. Let me know if you resonate with this video. Share. You know, if you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you know I'm about to upload my next video. Send out as much love and light and positivity as you possibly can. Know that you are truly blessed, highly favored, forever loved. And I'll see you on my next video. Peace. Be wild.